Restoration magic! I've never been able to pull that off before. I wonder if it might work on something else. So shabby now, huh?
No, a cut like this is nothing. But this ribbon isn't so bad.
Cheshire said in a slightly embarrassed voice.
Yeah, I think it suits you perfectly.
Something made them stop. A strange presence. They were not alone.
Stop! We need to bring to a stand and sow the seeds of ruin in our kingdom. We will not allow him to wake a cursed child from his slumber.
It was the regal fairy from earlier.
Hey, that fairy's speaking our language. I think.
Fine, her insolence knows no bounds. Repent, for a king can know what snoop is not easily quenched.
The regal fairy continued his haughty monologue. Still, his thick accent was nigh unintelligible.
This is hopeless. It must be some kind of fairy dialect. So, what? Are you saying you're the fairy king or something?
Insolence! Before us all, bend the knee. Those with four legs bend too. Very trees of Avalon bow before us to pay obeisance. We are Pukar the Wise, Pukar the Magnanimous.
What? Okay. So it was you who did all that awful stuff to Cheshire. I see a royal behind in need of a good spanking.
Cheshire looked happy to oblige.
Human and demon dead challenge Puka, whose name strikes fear across all three realms.
Yeah.
it. All right, back to business.
Because.
fix it. This.
The two sensed danger in the fairy named Pooka's words and began to run.
You live a fairy kingdom. Not me, Pooka.
What? Guy. Hmm? What are you on about? What the? Oh, give me a break!
Realizing what had happened, Sarasa hurriedly began wiping her face clean. The spectacle was too much for Cheshire. He rolled with laughter.
It's personal. That creepy fairy best hope we never cross paths again. Okay, Chocolpus, joke's over. All right, let's get a move on.
Sarasa frowned and stormed off. Trying unsuccessfully to control his laughter, Cheshire followed after. But each glance at Sarasa sent him back into fits of seam-bursting chortles. The sphere burned with a bright red light. The two had arrived at the final elemental core.
that's number four. We destroyed all the elemental cores. You know what that means? Here's the last elemental power. Let's give it a try. Okay?
Cheshire gave an annoyed snort.
He'll show that smug face of his before long, I'm sure.
Cheshire, are you feeling better? Does it still hurt?
I'm fine.
Cheshire said nothing more. But Cereza could have sworn she heard the trace of a faint purr in his voice.
Glad to hear it.
Cereza let out a sigh of relief. The wolf seemed as energetic as ever.
You're going to take us to Lucaon? We must be getting close. Come on, Cheshire, hurry!
Morgana's ghostly form appeared. She took one look at Cereza and furrowed her brow.
Cereza, what have you done with your hair?
Sorry. I needed it for something.
Cereza explained how she had used her hair to save Cheshire.
For the sake of a demon! Cereza, never forget who is the master and who the subject. Under normal circumstances, now would come a stern lecture. But that will have to wait for your safe return. My spell is almost complete. I will have you out of that forest soon. Just hold on a bit longer.
Oh. Thanks, Morgana.
The fairies are a formidable foe. But use all I taught you and defeat them. May the moon light your path. Stay safe, Cereza.
Oh, I'll defeat them all right. And after that, I'll meet Lucan, get that power, and send you back.
Cereza and Cheshire exchanged a glance. Getting the power from Lucan would mean the end to their journey. It would mean saying farewell.
Come on. We're almost there.